rolling, right?
Okay. So
what?
Okay. So no. Hi, I'm Izal and this is
Rudy.
Yeah, we are. What are we doing today?
We are unboxing the decade.
Okay, so first topic.
Let's see what we got. Hope it's something fun. I don't know how to explain this, but let's just say cars and food.
Okay. To me, when you say cars, this decade, ride hailing and also food delivery.
Got it right.
Right. Okay, so do you like it? Don't you like it?
I love it. The fact that I can just stay home, order food, they deliver it to me. I don't even have to get off my bum. I think that's great. Yeah.
Yeah.
Next topic.
Next topic.
You pick.
Oh. Okay, so this is a topic that I don't know much about.
You don't know anything.
No. I don't know anything, but okay. But then it is a phenomenon I think everyone is trying to open. Okay, if you look at it, it is tea.
Oh, that's easy. Boba.
Yes, you are right. Boba. But I have a question though.
Yeah.
Boba and bubble tea are the same thing, right?
I found out that boba and bubble tea is not the same thing. Well, it's sort of the same thing, but boba and pearls, right? So boba is apparently slightly bigger than pearls, which I didn't really understand the point of and whatnot. But apparently it's been a whole phenomenon across Asia and in the past couple of years, in this decade, across the world actually. And it's just been a boba explosion everywhere. You have people queuing up for drinks and all that. I don't even know why, but do you like it?
It's a love-hate relationship. I think I like the milk tea part, the boba, is that what you call it?
You prefer boba fat?
Boba fat.
Okay, next topic. Let's see what we got. Ooh, it's another food thing. It's got something to do with salt.
Okay, I know. Okay, so it's salted egg yolk covered in everything.
Correct. Everything covered in salted egg yolk.
Okay, you know, actually, you know what? I call it like heart attack food, but the thing is, it's so damn good, man.
Yeah, you know, they do salted egg and everything now. Actually, speaking about that,
yeah,
even boba, they had boba pizzas, boba like pasta, boba, I don't know what else. And with salted egg, they've got salted egg crabs, salted egg squid, salted egg chips, salted egg fish skin,
no,
salted egg
chicken
croissants.
Skin. Salted egg chicken skin. That one was like,
yeah. Maybe they're gonna do salted egg boba next.
Maybe. Moving on.
Oh. You know a lot about this. You chill.
What? Netflix and chill.
Okay. Netflix and chill.
Netflix and chill. Okay, cool. I think that is the great part about this decade. Like, practically you can consume content anywhere, everywhere with anyone you want. Right? Netflix, big player. Spotify, big player. Hulu, we don't get it here where we're at. But then we have people like Disney Plus and stuff. I mean, it has created like a whole new culture or content consumption altogether.
Yeah. Even YouTube,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's like given a space for creators and vloggers to start creating content and really share the world with the rest of you out there.
Correct. Alright.
Destination of the decade.
I'd like to say Bali, but then I think that has changed. Because looking at the patterns and everything of like pop culture altogether, right? I would say South Korea.
That's correct. South Korea. Correct.
I like it because they became the new cool country of Asia.
Yeah.
Right? They overtook Japan. Yes. To me, I think Japan has always been a very cool country, but they've overtaken that. The only thing about it is that when I see Instagram, like people that I know that go there, what they do, I don't see much cultural stuff. It's more of, you know, I'll go to like, this is where they shot this drama.
Yeah, because it's all about the K's, right? You've got K-drama, you've got K-pop, you've got K-food. I guess, or something like that. Anything with K in front, people love. Next topic.
Okay, hold on. Okay, so this topic, okay, is like the... I think it defines the whole decade.
It defines the whole decade?
It defines the entire decade. I mean, it involves photography, it involves...
Kanye West!
No. Kanye West lied to us the whole decade, right?
No.
But he made his way. But practically, it's all about the... experiential. It's about the experiences, sharing experiences.
doing it for the gram?
Correct. Exactly.
So doing it for the gram, I'm sure everyone has done it for the gram. Is it doing it for the gram?
Yes.
It is doing it for the gram. I'm sure everyone has done it for the gram before, you know, going to Bali just to take pictures or going to the new Bali, Lombok.
Lombok, yeah.
So the other thing that Instagram has really brought to this world is influencers.
Yeah.
An opportunity again for more creators to go out there and basically just make bucks from traveling.
Yeah.
Well, apparently it's a thing.
It is a thing. I've seen like music festivals, like people go there alone and they're like just chilling. And then, but there's a big scene behind them and they just go dancing and then they just take a picture and then they sit down again. Yeah, but it's created that lah. That's the other
problem. That's what you do.
No, that's not what I do. People take pictures of me.
Apparently.
Okay.
Okay, this is a style thing. You and I have gone through this phase before.
Emo nights. No.
No?
No.
That was the previous time.
Okay, I know. Okay.
It's a style thing.
Okay, so I used to have long hair, so I know what he's talking about. Yeah, we all had man buns.
Yeah, we all had man buns. I had a man bun too. He had a man bun too.
But my man bun looked cooler than his man bun.
Yeah, his just looks like a shaggy poof. I don't know what his hair is. Mine wasn't really a man bun. I had like a man bunny tail thing.
Bunny tail thing.
Your turn.
Oh yeah, my turn. Aha. Ooh. Hip-hop, regional,
music.
Yes.
Festivals.
Music festivals.
And music festivals.
The rise of Asian artists.
Yeah.
That's kind of cool. I think it has been a great decade for that.
It is. It's been a great decade for music in Asia. Southeast Asia especially, there's been a lot more music festivals happening. A lot of people have been traveling to this region. You've got Wonderfruit in Thailand.
You've got Cock-a-Flap in Hong Kong.
Yeah, you've got It's the Shift that goes around Southeast Asia. I think there's a lot of great stuff happening here.
Yeah.
Even artists, right? You've got like great talents from Southeast Asia like Rich Brian from 88 Rising. Yeah. And just recently, you know, AirAsia announced Red Records. And you've got Janine Weigel. I think the next decade, you know, forget K-pop and all that, it's going to be about A-pop. ASEAN pop. Oh, my favorite one, last one. So, it's about a cat. The decade started with this cat. It's the coolest cat on earth. In fact, this cat is so cool, I think this cat literally started a whole internet meme culture.
Nyan cat.
If you guys don't know what the Nyan cat is.
So the whole decade was all about cats.
It was called the Decats. So we're gonna close off the decade doing one of the most annoying things that ever happened this decade.
Yeah.
Happy New Year.
Because
he doesn't know how to dab, I know how to dab.
Because this is the real dab, right? No?
No. The other most annoying thing is when people try to dab, but you know all they're doing is this. You know who does that?
Yeah, my mom and dad.
And then, you know, all that. Dragon Ball.
Yep, correct.
Ken?
And my hand.
So, some other fun facts that happened this decade. Both of us got married.
Not to each other. We almost, but no.
No. Separate wives, separate lives.
Yes. But happy.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Bye.
Bye.
Have fun. Follow us. Why I did that, I don't know.